Right, as most of you, I was pretty disappointed that the new GRX 12-speed Di2 didn't come in a 1x specific setup, but doesn't mean we can't try, even though this is the RX825, which is a 2x specific, if you wanna call it that, as you can see here. And what is it? Yeah, max 36 tooth cassette. But that doesn't stop us from doing a bit of experimenting, which is the plan. But before we get into all that, I just wanted to put this on the scales, although it's been weighed by a lot of people already. I always wanted to check for myself, of course, do some quick comparisons. I don't have the old 8, 15, 11 speed with me anymore, but I still have some footage of that being weighed in, so I will insert that as well, so we can see how much this has gained, because yeah, they needed to put in the whole charging port, I guess, there, and the whole wireless chips and whatnot. So it has gained some weight, that's for sure. Do you get anything else in this box? I'll get the Di2 cable tool and V-screw guide. And what is this? Some rubber grommets and that little cable thingamajig. We won't be using any of those because we're going way out of spec. At least that's the plan. So the big point with this is, of course, this clutch. It's pretty tight even without the clutch on, but yeah, gets a bit stiffer. Yeah, but like the Ace derailleur has way less tension even without the clutch. Interesting. Let's see. As you can see here, there's about, how much is that? 1.5 centimeters longer gauge. And that is, of course, only to take up that extra chain slack. So even if you would like put a longer cage on, it still wouldn't really make it compatible natively with a bigger cassette, because the actual geometry of the parallelogram, or whatever you call it, is still optimized for a max 11 to 36. But like I said, that doesn't mean we can't experiment. Not in this video though, that would probably go on the main channel. So let's just check some weights to start with. So the derailleur itself, fully equipped, 309.5. And I will insert the clip from the old RX815 11 speed here, hopefully. And just for comparison's sake, since I have the derailleur here, that is 1 to 17.2, so that's quite a big difference. But keep in mind that this is the Ultegra level derailleur, and we have a clutch to take into account as well. What I wanted to check as well was the direct mount link, because this will be one of the experiments we'll do. So that link is 15.5. So what I will experiment with is this. This is the Wolf Tooth Road Link DM for direct mount. 16.5, and the Bluetooth is 20, so we're adding a bit of weight, or a few grams. So with this on, it will clear bigger cassettes in B-screw wise. Again, it won't really affect actual geometry of the parallelogram, so even if it can clear a bigger cassette, it doesn't mean that it would be optimized for a bigger cassette. So, but yeah, like I said, it's always fun to experiment, and I'm not too crazy picky about is it doesn't need to be at the crispy level of this, as long as it's usable. But again, that will be a video for the main channel, so stay tuned for that. While we're at it, let's check the derailleur link and see if there's any difference in weight between that and the GRX felt lever. Yeah, it is. If you have a spare D-link for the derailleur, you can actually use it on the GRX and save a few grams on that if you want to. Good to know. You see, I try to keep these videos short, but I keep coming up with things to check once I start recording and they get a bit longer than expected. Sorry about that. But until next time, peace out.